Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel Nest Artfully. Here I talk about everything that goes into making a house your home. In today's video, we're going to look at how to decorate terracotta pots. Now I've already done a video on this topic and I will link into it. You can watch it after this video. So we're going to look at a few other ways, few more DIYs that are extremely simple and anyone can give it a try, and it'll give your terracotta pots a more beautiful look. Before we get into doing up our terracotta pots, something I want to put out there is, I don't have the materials to show this, but if you want to make sure whatever you paint or design on it lasts for a long time, then ideally, before you even get started with painting, give your terracotta pots a water-based primer coat, both on the inside as well as the outside. Then go ahead with painting and designing your pot. And once you've completed this, make sure to seal it. Now you can use an acrylic sealant varnish, or you can go for a sealant spray, which is easier to do. This will ensure that your painting, illustration or design, whatever you've done on the terracotta pot, is protected from weather and other elements and stays that way for a long time. And as the light startled our eyes, we let go of disguise. And now there's something in the air, and a sparkly shimmer on our skin. Terracotta pot is complete, and I went freehand on this one because I posted a picture of this type of pot before and a lot of you had asked how I went about doing it. I sold that one, so I've done it again, and this pot is just really simple. It might look complex, but it's actually very simple. I've given it a white chalk paint base, and then on top of it I've gone with a black marker and done a very abstract piece of illustration. So I've just drawn leaves first, the outlines, and then filled it up with black lines. The eyes, the nose, the mouth, everything is kept simple and abstract. So it's something you can definitely try. Try it out on a paper first if you're uncomfortable doing it on a pot straight away. And any mistakes you make, you can always cover it up with a little bit of chalk paint and go again. So I think it's something that looks unique. Again, you don't have to worry about color combinations. It still looks very pretty without doing much. So something you should definitely give a try.
Souls out of sand, reaching for the grand. As willows align, we lose track of time. Head up high, now we climb. Oh, dreamy, breezy, we go easy.
Second terracotta pot is now complete. This is a popular technique on the internet and I really wanted to give my hand at it. So we've gone for the marble technique here, and we've used three colors, white, black and gold. Now, the only issue with this technique is that you really have no control over the final outcome. So you might have some pots that you don't really like the final look of, and some might just come out perfect. The few tips and tricks that I feel I can give is to try and do the spray paint within a container which is a little broader, so that it gives you more ease of movement to roll any pot or anything that you're using on top of the spray paint. And with the spray paint itself, make sure that you have the colors that you like in sufficient quantity on top of the water. Go at it in terms of like a test or a trial run, which we also did with some plastic cup or any other piece of material that you have and you don't mind throwing away, and then give it a try on your pot.
To settle down, day nights and late nights, don't kid around, but there's something about you, something about you I like, about you I like. You're crazy for saying I should slow down, but maybe I'm escaping the love we found. There's something about you, something about you I like. Get too drunk and too scared and lie to you. If only you knew I would die for you. One of us, gotta say the obvious. Nobody loves me better, nobody loves me better. Nobody loves me better. Guess I'm just scared to settle down. There'd be many nights I got too high and almost left town. But there's something about you, something about you I like, about you I like. I get too drunk and too scared and lie to you. If only you knew I would die for you. One of us, gotta say the
I've completed the third set of terracotta pots, and for this I've been inspired by the sprays that are available which give you a textural finish, like a stone finish, instead of giving you a paint finish. Now I wanted to try and replicate this at home without having to buy the spray can. So I've gone ahead and experimented with some items that I already had at home. Chalk paint was the base, to which I added some sand and then baking soda, of course, to give it that texture. And then to hold the whole concoction together, I added white glue. Now when I applied it on the pot, I wasn't sure how the final outcome was going to be, but I let it dry and the texture is just so beautiful and amazing. Now I've added gray to my chalk paint here in terms of black, a little black paint, and it's given me a cement finish. But if you were to add, let's say, chocolate brown or red or any other color, it can give you a very different finish. Now, that being said, so that was the bottom component of this pot. I wanted to contrast it with a smoother aspect on the pot, and so I went for the dip and drip technique, where I just dipped the top of the pot in some paint that we had remaining from our arch wall project, and then I kept it upright and just let it drip organically. And it's got such a beautiful look with such minimal effort. And if you want to avoid the textural finish, which is the mimicking the cement pot or the stone look finish, then you can just do the dip and drip technique on a plain terracotta pot. So this keeps the porosity intact, and whatever drips on the inside, I finished it off in a neat way by just painting the entire inside. So this is the other option, and this is very easy to give a try at your home. So before we get into this treatment, I just want to say why it's very useful. Now, if you have old pots such as these with water stains, or you already painted it in the past and that has peeled off and worn off, you can do this to give it a new look very easily. So we're going to try doing a decoupage with fabric, with some old fabric that too, and upcycle both the fabric that we are about to throw away as well as a pot that looks like this into something really beautiful.
Gotta say the obvious. gotta say the obvious. Nobody loves me better yet. I get too drunk and too scared and lie to you. If only you knew I would die for you. One of us, gotta say the obvious. Nobody loves me better. Nobody loves me better.
The fourth terracotta pot is now complete, and I went with the decoupage technique on this one. I used some pretty motifs from an old bedsheet that I had and used a white chalk paint base, and then just went ahead with the decoupage medium mod podge and applied these bits of fabric on the pot, and we have such a pretty pot from what it initially was. It's a very simple technique and a great way to upcycle both old pots and old fabrics at home. With that, we've come to the end of this video. I really hope you enjoyed the techniques we've shown today. And if you want some more, you can look at my previous video on how to paint your terracotta pots. If you like these ideas and you would like to see more such content, do remember to subscribe to my channel. And as always, thanks for watching and have a great day.